Ladies and gentlemen, guys and girls, my name is Raven and welcome back to my channel. And welcome back to another Raven's Ramble. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the fact that Roman, he left the For Honor team while I was on my bit of a break. And this is a very, very big thing because he was the creative director, the lead developer, the head honcho of For Honor, essentially. And I'm honestly surprised that a bigger deal wasn't made about this because this is a very, very, very big deal. Especially when it comes to the state of the game and just the game in general and what's going to be going on in the future when it comes to For Honor. So we're going to talk about all that in this video, about my thoughts and opinions on him leaving and what this means for Honor in terms of the future. And overall, just what's going on now that he has left. So first of all, let's read his statement that he put out. So he says, "Hello Warriors, these past years on the For Honor team has been an incredible experience, intense and exciting. When I think about the Stickmen prototypes from 8 years ago and looking at the game now, I can't believe what has been accomplished. I'm incredibly proud of the game and what the team has achieved. There has been ups and downs, but it's always been fun. There was never a dull moment such as our first presence at E3 or playing a live multiplayer game during the press conference. The moment the game went live on Valentine's Day, the excitement of operating a live game, and of course the Warriors Den. The first E3 where they announced the Wu Lin was fucking spot on. That thing was awesome. But outside of that, the next E3 was really, really bad. And now that time has progressed, I know why that E3 was so bad. It was because they're scaling back For Honor massively. The content is really, really light with the game. They had nothing to show at that E3. They blew their bucket with the first E3 where they announced the Wu Lin, the brand new faction and everything. And then I think after that, funding got cut. So essentially, that's why the next E3 was pretty lackluster and shit. Not to mention the exact same thing has happened with the Warriors Dens when Eric Pope left. As soon as he left, the Warriors Dens became pretty damn shit, pretty sparse. There's not much on when it comes to those. Yeah, they show some cool things every now and then. But Eric Pope, I give him a lot of credit because he made sure that there was content every single week, at least. Like, the times when there wasn't any content on the Warriors Den were very, very light. It was like maybe one out of like 15 shows there was not much to talk about, but for the most part, Eric Pope made sure that there was always something to talk about on the Warriors Den. So I do gotta give him props for that, but of course the Warriors Den has lackluster now. The E3 was lackluster, and it continues to be lackluster in terms of the stuff that we're actually getting, especially with this year For Honor. But I digress. Moving on, he says, "After 8 years on the project, I've learned a lot, and I wanted to let you all know that I'm moving on to a new project within Ubisoft. I've taken time over the past few months to work on the transition with the team as I move into the new project. Most importantly, I wanted to take the time to appreciate the impact that this game and you, the community, had on my career. The team of For Honor is amongst the best I've worked with. While my journey on For Honor might be coming to an end, the communal vision that has guided this whole team since the beginning remains, along with the team members like Pascal Lee Rocks and Steph Jawinski, Andrew Jang Woon, and Nico Brombre. Who will lead For Honor into a strong year 4 and beyond." Now, there's a lot to unpack here, and this is, it's going to hit on another point that I'm going to be talking about later on. But essentially, you have Pascal, who we haven't really seen much of. You have Steph Jawinski, which is pretty cool. Steph, at least we've seen a bunch of him. Same with Andrew Jang Woon. We've seen a lot of those two. Nico, I don't know that guy, so I don't know what he's exactly doing. He's probably been on the Warriors Den at some point, but I don't really know the Nico guy. So in reality, you have one guy stepping down and then four people taking over from what it reads here in order to try and guide this whole project into the future. Now, that is one very, very, very bad that you have to have the main guy step down and walk away. We had Damien leave as well. Of course, he was the big data guy, the second in charge. He left. You had Eric Pope leave, and now we have Roman who's left. So when it comes to the balance of For Honor, yeah, Steph is going to make sure that things are nice and balanced. The game is, you know, getting towards a point where it's really, really balanced in terms of what it used to be. So it's probably at the best state it's been in a very, very long time. When it comes to armor and all that sort of stuff, it's very, very lackluster and few and far between lately when we've been getting armor. We did have an armor drop recently, but it was waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting. waiting just to get that fucking armor drop, and it's going to be a long time before we get the next lot of armor. So it's going to be very interesting to see what these guys do. They said year 4 and beyond. Now, I don't know what that means with the beyond part, but at the same time, that could just mean that they're going to go for a year 5, maybe a year 6, or they're just going to keep the game going in some shape or form. But he caps it off by saying, I want to thank all players, all the members of the community, and all the incredibly passionate people that have contributed to build For Honor, the whole For Honor. It has been an amazing journey, and I'll see you guys on the battlefield. He'll still be around. So that's completely fine. Now, I already know the argument some people are going to make and most likely have already made, and that is the guy's been on the project for 8 years. He just wants to move on to something new. You get bored of something after 8 years. This doesn't mean that For Honor is doing bad or there's anything wrong with For Honor just because this guy's moving on to another project after so long. They said the exact same thing when Eric Pope moved on. They said the exact same thing whenever Damien moved on. And I want to counter that with the most logical argument possible, and that is the fact that when something is going good for you, why would you ever walk away from it if it's good? If you're in a job that you love and you're making fucking a shit ton of money, you're not going to walk away from that. 8 years, 12 years, 15 years, 40 years, you're going to stay in that job because one, you like it, and two, you're making a shit ton of money from it, so you'd never leave that thing. If you're in a relationship with someone and you guys are deeply in love and everything is good and everything's great and you get along like a house on fucking fire, you're not going to walk away from that relationship after 8 years, 10 years, 20 years, 30 years because it's going really, really well. You people only walk away from stuff when it's going bad or it's stagnated and there's nothing else left to do with it. And that's exactly what's happened with For Honor. If you looked at the content schedule from when For Honor's first year when it launched to now, we went from getting 2 heroes every fucking season to now getting 2 heroes in the entire year. That's down from 8 heroes in a year down to 2 heroes in a year. If that doesn't show you that the game is not doing well, then nothing else in this world will. And that's exactly why Roman's moving on. He spent 8 years on the project. The project is dead in the water now. The guy wants to move on to something new because he's like, well, For Honor's not really going anywhere. There's no future For Honor in terms of, like, you know, big massive changes by the sounds of it. So he's sort of just tapering off and moving on to the next project. If they had something massive in the works, like a For Honor 2 or something like that, he wouldn't be leaving. He'd be staying for that, especially because he would know what he's doing and he's going to be making the big bucks if he did stick around for that. Once again, it comes down to if everything's going really, really well and you got big things on the horizon, you're not just going to walk away from that, regardless of how many years you've been at the place already. Now, it's going to be interesting to see what new project he moves on to, because he said he's moving on to a new project within Ubisoft. So it's going to be interesting to see whether that's going to be a brand new title or whether that's going to be something that is already out there or something that's in the works. Who knows? But I'm really, really keen to see what he moves on to and what he does. Now, for the most part, when the game first launched, Roman was a bit of a dick, okay? Everyone knows that he was a little bit of a dick and he was a little bit standoffish and defensive when it came to the fact that the game was fucking up in so many areas. He fixed that though. It got to the point where he ended up saying, yep, we fucked up, which they did. And then he ended up saying, we need to fix this stuff, which they've done for the most part. And anyone who's been watching me for a long time, you know that when something goes wrong, I point it out. When something goes right, I point it out. Now, For Honor has come a long way in terms of making the game fucking viable, and they've done a really, really good job at keeping this thing going and keeping this thing together. Now, it's all fine and dandy to keep something together and keep something going, but you also have to make sure that you're making enough money in order to fund future projects and fund content and push out enough content to keep everyone interested and happy and so on and so forth. But Roman has left, and that shows without a shadow of a doubt that the game is not in a good spot, because once again, if it was doing really well, he would not be leaving. He'd be staying for it unless there was some drastic brand new project. Right, you would not leave a golden goose to go chase something else unless you knew that other thing was going to be a golden goose as well and you want to really experience it. There's so many analogies to bring up here, but it's true. You're not going to do something else when you're doing something that's good and it's working and you're excited for it. And also, you got to remember that this is mostly going to be fluff stuff, okay? He can't just walk out and go, the game's a load of shit, the game's in the shit, and they have no future, bye, and walk away. He has to obviously fluff it up because he's still within Ubisoft, okay? So he can't sit there and say, yeah, the game's got all these issues, the game isn't going to go anywhere, so I'm leaving the project. He has to fluff it up and make it seem like, listen guys, I've been here for ages, now I gotta leave, now I gotta go. The game's in the perfect spot, it's going great, the new leadership's gonna fucking crush it, smack it right out of the park, okay? But I personally just have to step away for my own reasons. He has to make it seem like that, because otherwise Ubisoft will can him and he wants to go to this new project. So of course he has to fluff it up. That's why he says, who will these four guys will lead For Honor into a strong year four? You got two heroes releasing. How can it be a strong year four if they had fucking eight heroes in the first year and now you got two heroes in an entire year? That's not a strong year four. That's a pitter-patter. That's losing steam and losing steam fucking fast. And of course, the Beyond is to give hope and say, listen, there's going to be more and Beyond. We don't know what Beyond means. He could have said they're going to be strong, leading to a strong year four, a year five, and a four and a two. He could have said something like that, but he hasn't, because then that's giving guarantees on stuff. If he just says and Beyond, that could mean a year five, that could mean a year six, that could mean four and a two, or that could mean that they're just going to go year four and that go into maintenance mode and keep the game going with minor updates. That's Beyond. That's still going. So he's left that very open-ended, very ambiguous. Overall, I'm going to miss the guy because he was doing really, really well from about, I'd say, where we say, from Marching Fire. From Marching Fire onwards, he really, like, you know, came together and he was doing really, really well. I wish him all the best in what he's doing in the future. I'm really excited to see what project he's moving on to. But I fucking love For Honor. I love this game. And just seeing the fact that he's now leaving on top of everyone else that's already left, it really just keeps painting this big fucking picture that shit is not good. Shit's not going well. Because if, once again, if it was going well, all these people wouldn't be leaving. They'd be staying with the thing that's doing really well for them. So the fact that he's left now and he was the top dog is very, very bad. But I have ranted enough about this, so thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, and let me know your thoughts. I love reading and replying to all your comments down below. I tried to get to as many as I possibly can, but there's so many of you these days, it gets a little bit hard. Make sure you check out my social medias down below in the comment section, and also my merchandise page down below if you want to pick up some Raven Gaming merchandise. T-shirts, hoodies, pillows, whatever you want, I got it down below. And with that said, I shall see you all in the next video. Have a good one, guys.